And good morning, you guys. Today we're gonna talk about 10 things that I wish I knew before I started a YouTube channel. Before we get going, I kind of want to introduce you to my my lovely fiance over here. This is Ava Lovinet. She's also a full-time YouTuber, so head over to her channel. But I've been on YouTube for 9 years now total, and I figured it's time to share some knowledgeable information because I believe that through those 9 years, hustle, grind, sweat, tears, I picked up a couple of things that might be of high interest to someone wanting to start a YouTube channel. Actually, let me put it like this. If I was able to travel back in time 15 years, knock on the door of young Martin and tell him something of high value, this would have been the conversation I would have had with myself. If you're new to me, my name is Martin Solhaugen. I'm a full-time travel filmmaker and YouTuber. I made over 350 videos for my social media channels from travels all across the world. So if you like content like this, or if you want to get more insightful content, please consider slamming that subscribe button down below. So when I started YouTube, it was simply because Facebook blocked me from uploading videos to their platform. And that's how I discovered YouTube. I started uploading my creative works. Fast forward 9 years later, and I'm currently making more money on YouTube than I would washing dishes in my first job 7 days a week. So it's become a very, very interesting platform, and that's what I want to share with you guys today. If you're starting, you need to watch the full length of this video. So I'm going to drop some really, really, really good tips for you guys. So YouTube has given countless creators financial freedom to pursue their dreams. And personally, I never thought I would have the ability to experience this financial freedom where you wake up every day and you choose what you want to shoot or where you want to be, depending on your YouTube niche. And I mentioned this before, this lifestyle feels unreal to me. And I think because I'm able to live this lifestyle and showcase that across my platforms, I'm getting all these messages weekly where people ask me how to get started, how did I do it, and if I have any tips or recommendations to how they can do it themselves. And that's why I decided to create this knowledgeable series where I share some insights and hopefully inspire people and help people get started and going. But enough talking, right? Let's jump into topic number one. So topic number one on this list that I wish I knew is brand building. I never realized how powerful it is to have a strong brand building. When you're doing brand building, especially for YouTube, you should start thinking about why are people watching your content. Keep telling yourself, come up with a reason why people should watch your content, and keep reminding your audience about the same thing. So you need to have a long-term goal for your channel and focus on a niche. A strong niche is how you will grow on YouTube in 2020. And this is where I stepped wrong when I decided to pursue YouTube full-time back in 2015. I didn't really have a clear niche, I didn't have a strong brand, and I definitely didn't give people enough reason to follow my channel. Follow the adventure, subscribe below, all of those things. Topic number two is topical videos. And this is all about making videos that are related to topics, places, or things that people search on YouTube. So before you do this, you need to ask yourself, who are you trying to reach? You need a plan and you need a strategy, and I think this is where I just stepped completely wrong with my content, and it probably cost me a lot of potential growth. So I'm gonna share a little personal story here, and it's when I lived in Hawaii, I gave myself the ultimate challenge. I said I'm gonna do 1 year of daily vlogging, and that's gonna take me to 100,000 subscribers. I was certain if I just kept on going, my channel would grow. And this was completely wrong. This is where I learned a lot. So I did all these cool things, but I really didn't give value to people. And I also lacked the understanding of how people search on YouTube, how people use the platform. You can't just put out content of you going on this really cool hike if you're hashtagging it wrong, if you're not making content that people want to watch. So what I should have done when I was living in Hawaii was I should have made hike videos, beach guides, general guides for people who want to travel around Oahu. I'm 100% confident that if I would have made topical videos from Hawaii, my views would have been a lot higher. And for topic number three, start as early as you can. It takes a lot of time for people to trust you as a creator, to recognize your face. So there are, along the way, there are people who are going to discourage you. There are people who are going to throw shit at you. But you can't mind those things. You need to focus on your long-term goal and your vision for what you want your channel to be. Climbing your mountain to fame is never easy in any industry, and YouTube is definitely not a walk in the park. You need to understand that. But there's really no excuse to not start. The way I did that is I started side hustling it while I was in college. But if you're starting later in life, you can still work your full-time job. I've seen a ton of creators doing that, and they start their YouTube dream on the side. This is a great way to get into YouTube. You will know once that switch happens where you're like, shit, I can do this full time now. Personally, I wish I would have taken YouTube way more seriously at an early age. I feel like I really didn't take it seriously until 2 years ago, to be honest. I've been on YouTube for 9 years, but I really didn't take it as serious. There's huge potential in this platform, and it's really not a lot that you need to do to get it started, to get it going. Topic number four is... Alright, let's sit up. Topic number four, guys, is pace yourself. And this is all about taking your time. It's going to take time to build a channel which you can live off. That's obvious. As I mentioned earlier, I did 220 daily video blogs, just hammered out videos every day. But I actually wish I would have gone a little bit slower in the beginning. 3 times a week would have been enough, and it would have given me enough time to think about what I was really doing. Why was I making videos? And I could actually look at the performance. I could spend more time in the research phase and make sure I was making videos that had a greater impact. It's an old saying where a little becomes a lot, and it's basically if you're making one little bad video every day, that becomes a lot of bad videos in the long run. So just spending some more time on really focusing on what's going on and actually analyzing how your videos are performing could be really the key to success. So don't give in to short-term pleasure of just creating. Don't do like I did. Pace yourself and believe in your long-term brand building. So I think where I stepped wrong when I started YouTube is that I didn't have a big goal to achieve, and I didn't have monthly goals that I was gonna try to achieve. I think by breaking your big goal into monthly, smaller goals to make sure that you're reaching that big one is really what you should do. Now, breaking a big goal into smaller goals is a skill I picked up later in my life. But honestly, by using this simple technique, it could really make you excel 100 times faster in your ideas and make sure that you're reaching your goals. If there's one thing that I want you to take with you from this entire video, it's that you need a well-thought strategy for who you're trying to become, what your channel is going to be about, and how you can build a sustainable and healthy lifestyle around your YouTube creation. And that leads us into topic number 5, which is guard your health. So when I said that you need to be able to build a sustainable and healthy lifestyle around your YouTube creation, this is exactly what I'm talking about. During my YouTube career, I've hit a wall several times, and I almost had mental breakdowns due to the fact that I earlier wasn't able to control my health. And this is because when you're starting a YouTube channel, you only really need to focus on the filming and the editing. But as your channel grows, you realize that, shit, I need to learn SEO, I need to learn Photoshop, I need to know more about cameras now, I suddenly need to know marketing and ad strategies and bid strategies. You just realize that your plate is getting more and more crowded. And if you did like me, where I promise one video a day, there's not enough hours to even do that realistically. So you're gonna hit a wall because you get so tired and you just keep on producing and promise yourself things that you really can't deliver. And it's actually a term for this, and it's something I picked up from a channel called Think Media. This guy, he's a genius. He talks about YouTube growth. And I do believe he is right. Once your channel is growing, you experience these skill gaps where you realize, I need to get all this knowledge now if I want to take it to the next step. And this is where creators experience burnouts. They got too much things going on and they can't really handle it all. So I learned that the hard way by doing daily video blogging. I think that's what really got to me. So that's my number one tip, is not do daily vlogs. Try to do 3 really good videos a week, and I promise you, you're gonna see some tremendous growth if you're monetizing what's going on and making sure you're optimizing every video, which we're gonna talk more about in the next topics. So topic number 6 is something I really wanted to talk about, and this is success is the journey. Through my life, I worked with a lot of different people, and I've done it myself. You forget to actually cherish the moments and remember that what you are doing is really your dream. And it's all about enjoying the journey and realizing that sometimes you win, and sometimes you lose, and that's okay. That's part of it. As long as you stick to your long-term vision and plan, you're going to be okay in the end. And I'm trying to remind myself that I'm doing my dream job. I'm part of this YouTube community, which is basically making me do exactly what I want to do in my life. And this is something I try to tell myself every day when I wake up. Focus on the positive things of what's going on around you. Enjoy the journey. And to add to this, I also want to say that don't define your success on the number of subscribers that you have. It's always good to have a goal, and my current goal is to get to 100k, right? It's this massive number that you really want to get to. But I'm not defining my success based on that number. I'm defining my success based on how I'm able to build my community, how you guys react to my videos, the comments, likes, you know, these are things that also matters a lot, not just subscribers. As a practice for this, I want you to tell yourself once a day why you love your job and what you are doing. Topic number 7 is the story is what counts. And this is also something I completely didn't understand when I started vlogging. Production value means nothing. It's not about the camera. It's really about how you're able to tell your stories. Don't look for an excuse not to start YouTubing. And I've seen people who do great videos on their mobile phones. It has crystal clear sound. Personally, I started on an earlier model of GoPro. I think it was a GoPro 5. It did not have a good sound, and I quickly realized that sound is very important, but not the whole aspect of production value itself. So the way you can get around this is you can either have a good microphone, or you can record your videos in environments that are not windy, like this one. Luckily I have a good microphone. Or in an echo environment inside your house. If you're recording inside, do a test clip, check that it's nice, because people really care about sound on YouTube. But the story is what counts, so spend time on developing stories that are engaging your audience. And topic number 8 is gonna get more technical, but it's very important, and it's optimization. And I've said it before, and I'm gonna say it again, optimization is key. And this is where you need to spend time on optimizing your YouTube channel, your description box, your banner, your social links. Everything needs to look good, and you can't really afford to miss a moment where someone is on your channel but they can't find something, or they don't know how to follow you on Facebook. Make it very clear that this is my channel, this is my niche, this is my Facebook, this is my bio, and this is where you can find me. Contact me right here. Optimization of your YouTube channel is super important. If you're thinking that, well, I don't really know how to design, well, there are free templates all across the web. Just go into Google and search free YouTube header. Free template YouTube header. I promise you, you're gonna get some good examples, and you're gonna get started that way. I think it's very important that when you first get people to click into your channel, that it's just like, wow, it just shines. People are like, okay, this is what it's all about. This I wanna subscribe to. I believe that that's very important. And if you're missing out on those moments, if people are coming into your channel and there's no banner, there's really nothing going on, there's not a clear strategy or niche, they might not click subscribe, and then you've lost that opportunity. In the video I recently made where we talked about how to make a travel vlog, in topic 10 I covered some of my best tips to how to make a thumbnail and how to write a title. And that's also very, very important when it comes to optimization of your YouTube channel. Guess what I'm trying to say is that I wish I would have taken it way more seriously at an early stage in my YouTube career. If I go back and look at my old videos, I'm like, no. But I did what I had to do, and I got to where I am. So don't get me wrong, I'm very, very thankful for that. I'm just trying to share some knowledge to how you might reach your goal faster. And now for topic number 9. I'm gonna actually change location, because this is so important to me. I'm gonna have to lay down for this one. This is important, and this is YouTube makes you money. Yeah, I actually believe that's very important to talk about. And that's because I used to spend 95% of my time management on social media, on Instagram. Now, it's a terrible, terrible mistake. I'm gonna try to explain why. Oh. Not easy, it's not easy, this hammocks, but I'll do my best, guys. All right, and yes, I do take notes. I consider myself an averageable smart guy, but I do need to have some notes in front of me in order to do this for you guys. I'm gonna try, okay. So on Instagram, what I've experienced is that my content, it dies after 48 hours. And after 7 days, I rarely get any more likes. I mean, the photo is not just gone, it's dead, it's shot, it's nothing is happening. So there's no way that you are getting paid by Instagram from posting a photo, meaning that the only way you can get paid is if someone reaches out to you with a paid collaboration. This means that if you're currently putting all your effort into Instagram, you are building an income source based on faith and hope that some brand will reach out to you and ask you to do a paid collaboration. On YouTube, on the other hand, you can make money on your videos, and your videos live forever. And this is something I didn't really realize until a year ago, and I kept sharing this knowledge to all my closest friends and even business people I come across. I try to tell them, on YouTube, my content lives forever. And this is because YouTube is closely linked to Google as the world's second largest search engine. When you go onto Google and you type in anything, if you search for something and you've been smart and you made a topical video, you're gonna appear in the search results. People are searching for things on YouTube, but on Instagram, it's just like scrolling. It's gone. 2 days, your content's gone. And it's so important, and I'm trying to share about this. I actually did a little print screen because there are two videos I posted 3 years ago in 2017, and they're still getting a lot of views every month. These videos are not just giving me views, they're giving me more subscribers, and they're monetized, so they might be giving me money as well. It's amazing. And I think the last thing that's very important to consider here is that before this global pandemic, my income sources were split 50-50 between Instagram and YouTube. But after this thing, what happened is that within 3 days, I lost all my contracts. My contracts are frozen. No collaboration opportunities, no new emails, nothing. It's gone, it's dead. And this is because that revenue source is built on, like I mentioned earlier, other people reaching out to me. If I post 10 photos, I can't control the income source. Nothing's gonna happen. If I post 10 videos to YouTube, trust me, something's gonna happen. So you might, what I'm trying to say is that nothing happened to my YouTube income. This platform is sustainable in itself, right? It's something that I can control. And I think this is a very, very important factor to consider when you are choosing which platform you're spending more time on. And for the last topic of the day, share, share, share. It's all about sharing. I wish I would have known earlier. Again. So I wish someone would have told me when I started YouTube that if I broke down my videos and shared it across my platforms, that might have been a good idea. And that's currently what I am doing. So I look at my YouTube like a pillar content platform, where I create the pillar content, long form content that is up to 20 minutes long. And I take that content and I break it into smaller pieces that I distribute across my other social media platforms. That's why you will see on my Instagram stories, I might do like a 15 second teaser to the big thing that you can swipe up to see on YouTube. This are important things to do. When I started YouTube, I just published to YouTube. I was a YouTuber. I didn't consider the importance of sharing what I was doing to the platforms where people also are looking for these type of things. But it's important that you start experimenting with how a video is performing on Facebook compared to Twitter, for example. There are different unwritten rules, so you should spend some time on the platforms and really get to know them to understand how you're gonna break down that content. So by doing this, you can always redirect traffic from other platforms into your YouTube and hopefully convert them into subscribers. And that way you can grow your YouTube from external sources. Pretty smart. Okay guys, and those were 10 things that I wish I knew before I started a YouTube channel. And I know I got very technical and a bit geeky on the end there, but I like to look at it in a way that the more you know, the better. So I really hope that you like this video and that you can use some of the tips that I gave you in the building of your own YouTube empire. Again, consider subscribing to my YouTube channel, as I do a lot of fun travel video, vlogs, inspirational guides, but also thoughtful videos like this where you can actually learn something for your own brand building. So would love for you guys to become part of my community. Smash that subscribe button down there and also ring the bell. That way you get notified. You guys know how that works. I don't even really have to say it. Right now, I'm gonna close this laptop with my and where I'm gonna go into my girlfriend over here. She has been spending all day working on a new video for her channel. It's quite exciting. We've been focusing really well, I think, on mindset lately, both of us. And that's kind of how I got the inspiration to make these videos as well. And just sharing it also makes me a better YouTuber. So you guys, let's grow together and believe in our dreams.
What's up?
I just tell them that we should believe in our dreams.
Yes.
And we will see you guys on the next video. Leave a drop in the comment section if you guys are missing the daily vlogs. I know you might be doing that, but you have to understand that I could never been able to make these types of videos if we were doing daily vlogs. But I kind of really want to do a day in life vlog soon, so if that's something you want to see, smash it below. All right, guys,
see
you. Bye.